Guardian. I woke up this morning and looked out across the gray mists of Trustland, and I've got to tell you, my heart just wasn't in it. I didn't want justice or revenge. It wouldn't bring her back. I felt tired. I didn't want to fight anymore. But then, out in the distance, I spotted a deployment of Shadow Legion moving through the fog, pushing a group of prisoners before them. It's not about me. It's about them. So I picked up my rifle, and I got to work. We've got to fight on. Not just because we're in the Vanguard, or Queen's Guard, or because we're heroes, or all that rot. Because it's what Amanda would have done. And that's good enough for me.
The Shadow Legion rounded up another group of captives from the outlying settlements last night.
The civilians are easy targets. Relocate everyone you can to the farm until it's safe.
Don't think we haven't tried, chap. We've brought in as many as we can. But most won't leave their homes. The best we can do now is free those who've been captured.
I perceive an affinity between worlds, a place where the Ascendant and Material Planes could converge. Secure this area, that a portal might be opened. Ancient warlocks hypothesized that the Ascendant Plane was once home to creatures of great power.
The Elixni too have these myths, but they are only that. This realm is now choked by darkness. It cannot be redeemed, only expunged.
Hasn't deployed any Shadow Legion forces here. Does it think the Taken are enough to hold it?
It may believe that only Hive have mastered the secrets of the Ascendant Plane.
Or maybe it wasn't counting on this level of Awoken involvement.
When Tekians, Splicers, and Guardians assemble, no door remains locked.
The barrier between worlds thins. An ideal place to re-enter the material plane.
That desire is not ours alone. The Taken are attracted by this instability. Eliminate their defenses to secure your passage.
captives have been in here a while. I hope the Shadow Legion hasn't done anything to them.
Amanda told me they were treated humanely, aside from some kind of pollution in the air.
Darkness permeates all in this place. The light of a balefire will diffuse it.
Like a paracausal air freshener. Target the most powerful Taken and collect their essences.
The light of your balefire will consecrate them, transforming them into weapons of singular power. Grief is a sharp blade. Used as a weapon, it cuts even the wielder. But sometimes the only paths remaining to us are painful ones.
We've all died countless deaths. But we still only feel loss from the outside in. Holiday. She died doing what was necessary to protect the people of the city. She didn't do it out of obligation or circumstance. She knew it had to be done. And she believed in it to the end. She had one life. And she used it to save us. She set an example for us all. I don't know what else to say. Amanda. I would give my light, my last life, if it would bring her back. I've begged before. It's a false hope. A lie. At every loss, the traveler is silent. Each path I take leads me to a grave. Cade. Sophia. Hakim. I failed them all. I love you, Amanda. I'm so proud of you. Forgive me.
One cannot hear Zavala's words and remain unmoved. That man has borne suffering enough for many lifetimes. That is the price we pay for opening our hearts. And as the voice in the darkness extends its reach, we know only that few will finish this journey with us, for the path is long. As the nebulae whirl and billow above us, we remain. We endure. This is our privilege, our duty, and our curse. Take heart, Guardian. Know that we will endure together.